So we're here with John, Samit, and Hussein from SprintRay, and they're going to tell us a little bit about their new crown material and print process.
Absolutely. Listen, we're thrilled to be here at IDS. It's kind of the World Cup of dentistry, as everyone knows. And this year, we're launching our new crown kit. So we're changing the game. We've changed the game so many times with new product innovation, but this one is really having a big impact in dentistry. The idea that we could print 6 crowns, you can see in the camera here, in less than, in this case, the material is probably 15 minutes. We also have a ceramic material we just launched in the U.S. a couple of weeks ago in Chicago, prints in less than 10 minutes. So think of that, 6 crowns, less than 10 minutes at a cost of $6 to $7 a unit. It just kind of blows your mind with what's possible in dentistry. How we've been able to do it is kind of a combination of things. Hussein, who's our co-founder here, obviously the product lead and responsible for anything that comes out of product. You want to talk? I know your voice is, but
I'll try it. So, you know, what we did was basically not just looking at the material or just the hardware. It was the whole portfolio of everything that you need to produce crowns in office. And we put out the resin, as John mentioned, the design software for it, as well as the crown kit, which then speeds up the whole process. It's part of our thinking about workflow rather than just a piece. And that shows our commitment to dentistry as a company that solely works on dentistry and everything.
That's really exciting. What's the post-processing like for the material? What's the time requirements, do you think?
So post-processing for this particular crown materials is very easy. These are not, you can just spray with alcohol and just wipe, spray and wipe. So the whole workflow from scan to print is under 45 minutes. We account for nearly, I think, 5 minutes of post-processing in there, but it can be done in seconds with practice. Scan to deliver. Yeah, printing is less than 10 minutes. So scan to deliver is 45 minutes, but just spray and wipe. That's it.
We talked earlier about the idea that the fact that why is the platform so small? Ceramic resin is expensive. So you don't need a traditional tank. You got to fill it up. You're going to put several, you know, $1,000 of resin in to print one crown. So the idea is we customize it again to the workflow, make it easy for the dentist. Small compartment, small resin tank, small platform allows us to heat the material to the ideal temperature to reduce the viscosity so we can print a crown quickly, reliably, consistently, and not using much resin. So it's, again, it's workflow for the dentist. It makes sense. And that's the magic of the crown kit. So this has been a game changer.
The smaller build tray, the platform and the resin tank leads to better utilization of the resin. Because now we are not wasting as much resin in the kind of residual in the tank. So this is actually high-value resin, and we are leading to a much better utilization than the larger tanks that were placed for other indications.
Yeah, it's really revolutionary. And I'm glad to see you did it, because now you're looking 45 minutes. That's a real chairside workflow time frame from start to finish.
Yeah. The other thing I would say is, and we hear it all the time, well, how long has the material been out there? Well, we've got scientific studies. We've had 10 months in the mouth of zero fracture, zero debonding, zero opposing wear, and it'll continue to go forward. But the science says the material is good enough. It is good material for placing a crown. Now it comes down to what's good for the patient. Is a single visit great for the patient? Is a patient that comes in that maybe can't afford a traditional crown, is it the opportunity to give them a solution at an affordable price? Is that good for the patient? We think it is. I mean, our vision, our purpose is really trying to create more access to care around the world. And this is one of those things that checks the box on that. And we tell a dentist, if you want to wait, use it to do your temps. I mean, what's wrong with giving the dentist 20 minutes of chair time back? Prep a tooth, leave the op, no polyvinyl impression, no chairside temporary crating, which typically aren't very good for the patient. If you're a patient, you feel it in your tongue. We've all done it. Doesn't feel like a very good crown. It's rough. Boy, my dentist, how good are they? It's not very good. You put one of these in as a temporary crown and give the dentist 20 minutes back of their time. It's a great solution. So even if a dentist said, I want to get comfortable with the material, I'm going to let my temps run long term. I'm going to do my own in vivo study. Now they've got the opportunity to do that with zero risk. So we're excited about how this material is going to move forward in dentistry.
And what's the situation with aesthetics in terms of shades and finish, translucency?
For the ceramic crown that we just launched in US, we have 8 shades. So it's a pretty broad portfolio. And in terms of aesthetics, again, I don't have one on me right now, but it's great. We have very high accuracy, good resolution, and glaze it, and it's good to go. So it's really good aesthetics. We are getting great feedback from the doctors.
I mean, it's just, it looks, it's a beautiful crown. And I tell Dennis, would you be proud to put that in the mouth of the temp of any patient and give you 20 minutes back?
That's what I'm currently doing with milling. Like my DA does the design, she does the glazing. So if I can just change that to printing, it's a no-brainer.
The difference between milling and printing is printing opens up the opportunity for any dentist at an affordable price to get into digital workflow. Not every dentist can afford or is going to buy a milling machine. And I think we see our technology in collaboration with mills. We're not, everyone says it's going to replace mills. Well, no, it's collaboration. But every dentist that has a scanner can take this workflow and implement it tomorrow. And that's the game changer.
They can have a mill with a really fine lab miller, but like a ceramic mill, the burr's 1.2, 1.8 millimeters. That's as fine as the fissures are going to be.
I think the other part with milling, it's complicated, is just the maintenance and the running the equipment requires a lot of expertise, and what you're able to do with 3D printers just makes that so much easier.
Absolutely. And it's never been a more exciting time in dentistry. And just wait another few months, another year, I mean, it just keeps changing. It's awesome.
All right. Thanks for your time, gentlemen.